Hola. Mi nombre es Eduardo.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Hola, mi amo Emilia.
Me gusta español.
Hola, mis amigos.
Salut, je m'appelle Niamh.
Bonjour, ça va?
Bonjour, je m'appelle Alex.
Salut, je m'appelle Darcy.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Charlie.
Bonsoir, je m'appelle Jacques.
Bonjour, ça va?
Salut, je m'appelle Florence.
Salut, je m'appelle Sophie.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Darcy. Comment t'appelles-tu?
Salut, je m'appelle Thomas.
Bonjour, ça va?
Ça va, je m'appelle Abby.
Today we're going to do an experiment into rates of reaction. So I've got here a beaker of some really ordinary dried skimmed milk powder, not particularly exciting. Now, if I was to take a flame to this, as it is in the beaker, not very much would happen. It might char a little bit, but nothing else, because there isn't much surface area to react. However, what would happen if I increase the surface area, or the amount of milk powder that is in contact with the flame? So what I'm just about to show you is when I increase the surface area by pouring this milk powder over a lit splint near the floor. Now I'm going to need to make sure that I put on my visor so that I am safe and ready to do this, but let's see what happens.
Ignite the light and let it shine just on the night.
Hi, I'm Izzy from Uplands and I take A-level physics. I'm in year 13 and today we're going to be looking at the waves topic. Here we have a string that is vibrating at a frequency of about 11 hertz. What we have here is a fundamental wave, this one right here, and here, the vibration is being sent out to this side, and then it is reflecting off the stationary side there, and the two waves are meeting, forming, so the two crests are meeting, and they form a larger crest. And then the two troughs meet on either side, creating a bigger trough. If I increase the frequency, we should get the second harmonic. Now, due to the wave equation, we are keeping the velocity the same, so the speed of the wave is remaining the same. So if we increase the frequency, then the wavelength should decrease because this is remaining the same. So if I increase the frequency, then the wavelength will decrease. So I'll change the frequency to 22 hertz. So this is the second harmonic. As you can see here, we have a node. This is where a crest and a trough meet. So I can touch it and the wave should keep going. The wavelength is halved because I've increased the frequency by two. So now we have two standing waves, which is what these waves are. So if I increase the frequency again, we should get the third harmonic, and this wavelength of this harmonic is 1/3 the frequency of the first harmonic. So now I'm increasing the frequency to 33 hertz. The frequency is three times as high as the original frequency. Now we have two nodes. If I touch them, they should continue. We have three standing waves, and the frequency is three times as high as the first frequency, so the wavelength must be three times as less than the first wavelength we originally had. So here we have the Rubens tube, and my assistant Will has kindly lit the tube up. So the fundamental frequency here is 230 hertz, so we will be seeing the first harmonic, so a fundamental frequency right now. So the sound waves are coming from here, from the speaker, and they're traveling down the tube, and they're reflecting off the other side of the Rubens tube, and where the two waves meet, they're creating the peaks of fire that you can see. Okay, this is the second harmonic, and the frequency here is double that of the first harmonic. So 230 times by 2 will be the second harmonic for this. The third harmonic we will see shortly. So now we have three peaks. So three peaks is the third harmonic, and the frequency here is three times that of the fundamental frequency. And now the fourth harmonic, we should see four peaks of fire. Great.
Good morning. This lesson, we're looking at different types of casting that you need to know for your A-level. You are going to be using these throughout your project as we go. The first one I'm going to show you is alginate. This is made from seaweed, so it's sustainable, and it is skin safe as well, which means that you can use it for body casting if you'd like to do that. And I'd like to use Tio, please, as my volunteer in a second. What I have prepared is some alginate, and you prepare alginate in bendy bowls like this so that you can flex it as you're mixing. It's a white powder. It feels a little bit plasticky and a bit chalky, but what happens when you add the pre-measured perfect amount of water to this is it will start to react. Now, what might happen if I mixed warm water versus cold water into my alginate? What might be the difference? Yes, Matt.
The warm water would react faster.
Correct, the warm water would react faster. Now, what you can do, you need to work quite quickly with this, and you need to encourage any bubbles, or any, not bubbles I suppose, but any blocks, any sections of the powder to come out. Now, immediately, hopefully you can see, that has gone really sticky, but it's not particularly wet. This feels like rubbery, it feels plasticky. Tio, up you come, please. Please can you use anti-lac on your hands? Or you did it when you came in, didn't you? That's fine, right, mask on, thank you. So, I'm going to take casting of your hand, and then we're going to do an inverted mould of that at the end, so you'll have a perfect casting of your hand to take with you at the end of the lesson. Please can you pop your hand in the tray? Thank you very much. Now, this is starting to set, hopefully, by pressing against, sleeve up, please, by pressing against the bowl, like when you're making a cake, you can kind of push out any rough patches. Right, ready? So it's going to be cold. So I'm going to pour it onto your hand. You can use your other hand to press this in between your fingers. Okay, off you go. Right, try and cover your hand with that. I'm going to pop my mask on. Hopefully not get alginate in my hair. And then I'll get the last bits out. Now, this is skin safe because it's made from seaweed. Other types of plaster or other types of casting things are not skin safe. So this, if any of you have ever had braces and you remember that mold where they put loads of stuff in your teeth and then you have to hold it in your teeth while they take an impression of your teeth. Some of you are nodding, you remember that. That's what this is. This is alginate. It's skin safe. Silicon is the alternative, but silicon, because it's plastic based, it's oil based, it means that it's You're doing well there, thank you. It means that it's not as good for the environment. Okay? Whereas, because this is made from a natural source, it is better for the environment. However, alginate only has a life of about 2 days, and then it will start to disintegrate, it will start to crumble and crack. If you submerge whatever you've cast in water, it will last for a few more days, but it's only a temporary thing. The payoff is that it's better for the environment. Silicon, on the other hand, will last for years and years and years and will still have a flexible, rubbery quality and a high quality impression like alginate. Okay, done. So you are going to stay there for a little while, please. Try not to wiggle your finger too much. And then when that's set, it will start to go hard. It won't heat up or anything, don't worry, it's skin safe. I want you to peel your hand back off, and then we can take your hand out and you can see a perfect impression of your hand. Or you can encourage it off the sides. That's it, that's peeling. Yep. Perfect. Well done. Okay. How does it feel?
Dry.
Dry? Does it feel like jelly?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, now, very carefully, I can't help you. Very carefully, peel that out from between your fingers, please. And you should hopefully see a perfect impression of your hand with things like your skin pattern, nails, knuckles. Yeah, look how perfectly you've done that. Well done. Tell us about that. What does it look like?
Well, my hand is like, it's very detailed.
It is very detailed. Yeah. Does it feel all like jelly?
Yeah.
Lovely. Right, thank you. You can pop that down. Well done to you.
This is Year 10's first ensemble performance, and this is Valerie. Off you go, guys.
There's no reason why this shouldn't work now, is there?
No.